While presenting the entity's ministerial policy statement for the financial year 2023-2024 to the Health Committee, the Executive Director of the Uganda Cancer Institute, Dr. Jackson Oriem, noted the increased number of foreign cancer patients who flock to Uganda Cancer Institute to receive free treatment. He noted that patients come from as far as Nigeria to get super specialized treatment at Mulago.
The Uganda Cancer Institute is actually the East Africa Center of Excellence in Oncology. That means it is not only serving Uganda, but is serving the East Africa population as a whole. And this is far important in addition, because we are serving one of the key pillars of the East Africa community.
Committee members have protested offering free specialized care to non-citizens. The committee chairperson, Dr. Charles Ayume, noted that it's not anywhere in the world where super specialized care is offered at no cost. Lead setters contend that the government spends much money to procure specialized medical equipment, which must realize return on investment, and asked hospitals to stop waiving fees for patients who seek super specialized medical care.
The world over, I've not come across any literature where super specialized healthcare is free. For those who have traveled all over the world, like Dr. Rutaigwa, I'm sure you can support, but I don't think if you fell sick in the United States, you'd walk into Seattle Cancer Institute and walk out freely. Whether it is cardiovascular, whether it is oncology.
Oriem explained that Uganda Cancer Institute has established itself as a center of excellence in the region, with 15% of its patients coming from abroad. He, however, noted there is no policy to charge foreigners who seek treatment.
It's just a matter of walking into the Uganda Cancer Institute, you'll get your treatment, irrespective of whether you're coming from Burundi, Rwanda, where. There is nothing that actually compels us to segregate you according to where you're coming from.
We are going to burn our resources out. This is, like again you said, it's taxpayers' money. But why would the whole of Eastern Congo and part of South Sudan come here at no cost? So there should be a gatekeeping mechanism. I know we are Pan-Africanists.
The Uganda Cancer Institute seeks 350 billion shillings to complete the establishment of a PET center to save over 300 billion shillings that is spent by Ugandans every year in seeking medical treatment abroad.
As a result of your support, and of course the motion moved by Honorable Cecilia Ogwal, we got immediately $66 billion, shillings, as a supplementary in the financial years 2021-2022, and that has enabled us to kickstart the process of having the PET center. So the second phase of that is now where we are, this current financial year. And as you realize from my presentation, we never got a shilling in this financial year towards that.
The Institute is grappling with inadequate wages to fund the approved staff structure so as to undertake a wider mandate of coordinating the management of cancer, inadequate funding for medical supplies, and lack of funding for regional centers in Arua, Mbale, and Mbarara. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.